face.
Yeah.
Praise him with the harp and lyre.
Praise him with timbrel and dancing. Praise him with the strings and pipes. Praise him with the clash of cymbals. Praise him with resounding cymbals. Let everything that has breath praise the Lord. Praise the Lord.
Thank you. Thank you. She has other degrees behind her, but most importantly of all those things is she loves God. So pray with me, each and every one of you, that as we pray for her, point this way and say, preach, preacher.
Preach, preacher.
Preach, preacher.
Preach, preacher.
Preach, preacher.
Preach, preacher.
Yeah.
After the next selection,
or two.
This one. The next worship here will be none other than the Reverend.
Yeah, yeah.
Bridget E. Gloucester.
Amen.
Amen.
Yeah.
Yeah. God way of saying it. And I tell you, to y'all, my grandmama said it to me. If I had 10,000 cars, I would still.
For your being here with your daughter, it is truly Amen.
It's always hard. Reverend, you'll be able to understand what I'm going to say. It's hard when you got multiple children.
Yeah.
You got multiple. You want more about one big man and more about the other one big man. It's hard. It's hard. And so I am counting myself profoundly blessed. And I don't even say that lightly, profoundly blessed. Because God will let you travel some roads and fall in love with some folks. And so I am so thankful and so profoundly happy to the Springdale AOE Church family. I love y'all. I miss y'all. But you know how God do what God do in the AME church. God do some things. And the last annual conference, God did a thing.
Yeah.
The last annual conference, He honored me wherever we could to come down the highway, way down 85, slide down 127, to pull off in Austin Avenue, moving down the street, coming down the 2018 Riverway. Look at the second Timothy. Beginning at the first stop. Beginning at verse 3 and continuing through verse 8. That is the book of 2 Timothy, the first chapter. Beginning at 3, continuing through 8, when you find it, go ahead and shout hallelujah. If you need to wait, sing me. So if you can hear, you don't know if you can hear what you have. 2 Timothy, the first chapter, beginning in verse 3, reading from the King James Version of the Bible, where we find written these words. I thank God, whom I serve from my forefathers with pure conscience, that without ceasing, I have remembrance of thee in my prayers night and day. Greatly desiring to see thee, being mindful of thy tears, that I may be filled with joy. And when I call to remembrance the unfeigned faith that is in thee, which dwelt first in thy grandmother Lois and thy mother Eunice, and I am persuaded that in thee also. Wherefore I put thee in remembrance that thou stir up the gifts of God, which is in thee by the putting on of my hands. For God hath not given us the spirit of fear, but of power and of love and a sound mind. Be not thou therefore ashamed of the testimony of our Lord, nor of me his prisoner, but be thou a partaker of the afflictions of the gospel according to the power of God. And I back this thing up. It says that when I call to remembrance the unfeigned faith that is in thee, which dwelt first in thy grandmother Lois and thy mother Eunice, and I am persuaded that in thee also. Wherefore I put thee in remembrance that thou stir up the gift of God, which is in thee by the putting on of my hands. For God has not given us the spirit of fear, but of power and of love and a sound mind. Can you go ahead and look at your neighbor? Just as nice as you want to, go ahead and smile and be real pretty like. Tell them, hold on to that. Hold on to that. Bless the Lord. Gracious and eternal God, our Father, we come once again giving thanks. Thank you, dear God, for your space in our moment, for this moment of space in this place, God. We thank you, God, that you brought us, God, this far, that you kept us, God, this far. That, God, you have brought us to this moment where, God, you are preparing even now to speak a fresh word. God, right now we thank you, God, for your service to Sister Bell and Carrie, God, and for how you have brought her, God, to this place for our hardest chapel. And, God, because you have brought her this far, we thank God that this morning is yet pregnant with possibilities. And so, God, right now, in the name of Jesus, we thank you for what you're doing in her. But, God, we know that you are not a respecter of persons. And, God, we're still here because you're not finished with us yet either. So, Father God, right now, in the name of Jesus, we pray, God, that you'll pour out your spirit, pour out your presence, pour down your anointing. Send even now a double portion. Send God the anointing and lift our heads. Send God the anointing and break somebody's chains. Send God the anointing to remind somebody that they can keep on running and you don't have your way in this community. And we pray, God, right now in the name of Jesus, that God will bring you from heart to heart and from breast to breast. That God, you'll touch this frail preacher out of the dirt. Even now, God, and lean up on God in every leading side that God, as I stand in this box, in my own strength, God, under your unction, under your anointing, speak God to your people. And sit down and take those ladies and hear God have your way. And we thank you that every minute that we experience, have your way. And God, we thank you for every way you show up. Lord, have your way. And we'll give you glory. We'll give you honor. And we will give you praise in the name of Jesus the Christ. We pray. We say collectively, hallelujah. Amen. Amen.
folks, including the pastor, who know what it is to find themselves in service to the Lord. Can I suggest to you that after all the roles and after all the titles, that you are left with a uncommon yoke around your spirit when you're called to be a service to the Lord? But when you are called to be a service to the Lord, it requires something of you. It requires you going beyond that which is comfortable, that which is familiar, to reach out to places that you know that if it can, if it was not from the Lord on your side, that there was no way that you could make it through. And can I tell you that is true not just for pastors, but anybody who is made up in their mind to serve the Lord.
Yeah.
the places where you start thinking if what you got in you is sufficient to handle what he's doing in this season. He'll put you in places where you start looking in the mirror and start wondering if God somehow made a mistake. He'll put you in places where sometimes you will look around and think that anything you can do is but throw in the towel and give up.
Yeah.
And as we were hanging out, we started talking about the challenges of trying to walk in and under the anointing under which you walk.
Yep.
And what we concluded is that no matter where you are in the journey, to be able to walk with the Lord will cost you something.
Yeah. Yeah.
That to walk with God, to walk in obedience will cost you something.
Yeah.
To love your neighbor as you love yourself will cost you something.
Yeah.
To humble yourself when folks rise up will cost you something. To hold your tongue when they talk about you will cost you something.
Yeah.
Show the evidence of God's presence in your life when everything is coming against you will cost you something. You keep on walking when you feel like throwing in the towel will cost you something. Studying when everybody else has gone to sleep will cost you something. To pray when everybody else has given up will cost you something. To see visions when everybody else has thrown in the towel will cost you something. Nothing cost. God calls you.
Yeah, yeah.
Yes. Look, just kidding, look, there's gonna be some stuff, and when you get to the stuff, I'm gonna lean on what you did, but I can lean on the remembrance of what God has already done. This is what I want you to do. When stuff is hard, verse 6 here is, it says, wherefore I put you in remembrance, that I store up the gift of God.
Yeah.
Can I tell you I went to school for half a second? This is a half. And when I went to school for half a second, they gave me an understanding of this concept of stirring up the gift. The stir up the gift is to indeed the word that is used is called to rekindle something. So to rekindle, first of all, suggests that there's already something there. You may have to find it, you may have to buy it, you may have to get oil lines, you may have to get your brake off of there. You may have to do nothing else but what God has put in you. It's already in you. But the phrase that they're using here in the language, the original language, to rekindle, speaks of a never-ending fire. It's a fire that no matter what comes, it does not go out.
Yeah.
It's the idea that the fire that is burning in you is supposed to be a perpetual fire. Serve the Lord well. Sometimes need you to serve the gift of God. Here it is, verse 7. For God hath not given us the spirit of fear.
Yeah.
But he's giving you instead power. He's giving you instead love. And he's giving you a sound mind. I gave you a clue a little bit. I talk about you now. He was scared of the dark.
Oh.
But because he was scared of the dark, he was always afraid to lay down and be still. Something about the quiet of the dark always made him uncomfortable. But we got to a place where we learned how to say it. He said, the Lord has not given you the spirit of fear.
Yeah.
The Lord has given power and love and sound. Took a little while from here.
Mm-hmm.
But after he started praying, the fact that God had given him the spirit of fear, but power,
my God,
and love,
yes,
and sound mind.
Uh-huh.
Can I tell you that idea that God didn't give him a spirit of fear allowed him to face darkness?
Yeah.
But the idea that God did not give him a spirit of fear allowed him to face stillness.
Yeah.
Every now and then,
yeah. You
with your saved and sanctified self
are
going to have to navigate darkness.
That's right.
Every now and then, with your saved and sanctified self,
you're
going to have to navigate
you
When we come to these special event moments, people get so caught up in the event that they miss the word.
Yes,
yes. Because, I mean, the world we hear the all the past is a word that each of you has. You've been going through something, and yes, it's a word for you. You've been finding yourself responding, worried, distressed. It's a word for you. There's something here in this house. And you know that if you're honest, you tell the whole thing to shake it down, because you don't really have a saving relationship with Jesus. Can I give you a hint? Just hang out on a few don't make you say. So maybe today, all you have to do is raise your hand where you are. Somebody can meet you where you are. Because every reason one of us has a question on you, that's what God led us. So, is there one who wants to give their life to Christ? Or maybe you have a prayer that you say this. This prayer of salvation with your eyes. You know, there's something along the way you start to pull away from it. You've got a little less committed to it than you should have been. Can I tell you, the God is so gracious. And so all you have to do is raise your hand and you cross. Raise your hand. And if they won't, or maybe this wonderful pastor here who has been going there and walk with God and going there and have to share the church. Maybe your desire is to be a member here on this chapel, maybe the church. Can I tell you, the doors of my heart of this church are open to you. Is there one? Is there one? We praise God for us. But even speakers get up.
And she just said to be authentic to yourself.
Yeah.
And that's what my mom always said. And before I knew it, I just became a little crybaby. And every kid was wrong.
Yeah.
Oh, you know, so like, it really, really felt like she was there. To my board of examiners, please.
It's gone, y'all. It's gone.